Something I noticed at the end of the last episode, since I left off in this bizarre Twilight Zone universe of an area, is that when you rest at the bonfire and you're go to travel, Untended Graves is what this place is called, and it pops up under the same place as the Cemetery of Ash, Firelink Shrine, and yeah, that's just kind of weird. So, am I in an alternate version of Firelink Shrine? Is that where I'm going to end up? I don't know, bro. I aims to fucking find out, though. Bet your ass. Free Shriving Stone for my troubles. And let's see. Yep, there's the fountain. But what is over here? Because this is where we first awaken, I believe. Oh. It's those guys. The little bird men. Well, let's say hello. Let's say hello with arrows to the dome. Or chest. Whatever. Yeah, you woke everybody up. That's not gonna mean much. Oh no, poison that couldn't possibly reach me. My only weakness. Yes, sarcasm. Okay, can I still roll? Alright. Now let's see if we can get some free backstabs. Free backstabs all day. There we go. That is how you fucking ambush. So this is... Well, I technically rose out of the ground back here. I don't think I woke up out of a stone casket. Maybe I did. I don't recall. That was way back at the beginning of the game. I got the Ashen Estus Ring, which I'm assuming, like, the Estus Ring would restore my FP. FP restore the Ashen... Yeah, increases. Yep. Sure enough. Interesting. What the hell is going on? So now it begs the question of which one is the real place? Is this the actual Ash Cemetery? What the hell is that back there? Well, it helps if you hit them. It helps when using a bow if you hit the enemy with the arrow. Who are you? You are trying to bleed me, and I don't appreciate it. There we go, I interrupted that shit. So these are the Grave Wardens, I believe. Pretty good looking. Yeah, interesting. Just go ahead and use deep protection because it's going to help me against getting bleed effects if that's what's going on over here. At the same time, I'm still left with the doggy. Ugh. Yes, I know you can hit me. What, did you think I didn't see you, doggy? Oh, shit. I thought this was a drop-off. I didn't think he could actually get up here. Man, I'm making all kinds of fucking stupid mistakes today, guys. This does not bode well for me. Jesus. I'm gonna get bled out if I'm not careful. I am playing like absolute ass. Fuck you. Sit down. Grave Warden Hood and Titanite Shard. Large Titanite Shard, more rather. Huh. Not a fan. Not a fan of this. God damn it. Ooh, Titanite chunk. This is what happens when you get a little too full of yourself. You start getting destroyed by enemies that earlier you had no trouble with. Now, begs the question of what kind of happy shit's going to be over here. Are we going to have more of those, yeah. Oh. Not one, but two. What we do not want is for two of these guys to get up. That would be terrible. I'm just gonna go ahead and do some of that. Yeah. Shit. Oh, this is bad. This is bad. Movement speed slowed down. Bad. Are you stuck there? I don't think you're stuck there. But what we need to do is keep them separated. Alright. Some area to maneuver. Fucking bye. Come on, bro. We're fighting over here. Oof. These things are so quick with their attacks. There we go. Ugh. Free Titanite scales for that. Okay, so we got one more to take care of. One more. What? Oh, for Christ's sake. I forgot I'm in, I'm embered. Who did I get invaded by? I didn't even see anybody pop up. Hello, invader. Oh. There they are. Hey. Right here. Hello. Is that an NPC invader? That's an NPC invader. We'll come back to that. Whew. Here I was worried that I was going to get my ass kicked by another player. That's okay. Even if I did, no big deal. Gotta admit, it's nice having deep protection, but it does fade rather quickly. I wish it would last longer, but I'd also wish that it was like a permanent status buff that made me invincible and made all of my attacks one-shot bosses. Since I'm asking for things from Santa Claus. Ouch. Dick. Come here. Sit down. Give me my Titanite scales. Go away. Now, what's interesting to note is that there's doesn't seem to be any shinies over here, and I figured with two of those things over here, there should be something awesome, but no, nothing. That sucks. Alright, well, whatever. What shield am I using? Still using the dragon shield. I like the shield of want better, honestly, because it allows, it gets you more souls per kill, but it also allows me to switch back and forth from my battle art, which I like the battle art for the katana. So let's see, and I'm sorry if you guys hear birds chirping, but there are some very loud fucking birds outside my house right now. Yep. Oh. Oh, you're trying to parry me, huh? I can do that. Oh my god. And soul arrow? No. What is that thing doing? Not much. Oh my god. What? Oh shit. That was almost terrible. Oh, what is this? I've got a dude coming at me? And she healed, okay. That's awful. I am in quite the fucking bind here, guys. Let's see, can I pop? I should have like a divine blessing or something I can pop, right? Yeah. There we go. Okay. Let's come back over here, see if we can settle this fucking invader's hash. That shit is annoying, man. Don't know what that magic is called either. What? Okay, bye. That was pretty anticlimactic and lucky. You know what? A victory's a fucking victory as far as I'm concerned at this point. There we go. Cleric's Sacred Chime. What? So this is also where there was a bonfire originally, and there is no longer one here. Which is kind of upsetting, because I really could use a, you know, refill. Hey! Dude! I'm gonna get killed by a regular fucking hollow. Come on. There we go. I don't think I have any other healing consumables, which is going to be a problem for me. Real quick here. Although, oh no, wait, that's right, killing the invader netted me some free Estus flasks. Aha. Oh-ho. I saw you. Luckily, this time I don't have to make any stew. Ooh, hidden blessing. Oh, that just restores FP. That's not. There's a lot of summon signs down there. Something else that's not inspiring confidence within me, currently. Is there an archer? Yep. Yellow. Is there another one? Oh no, he's just throwing knives. A lot of summon signs, and this is where I fought the, I can't remember his fucking name, champion, who is his fuck? Don't remember how exactly to pronounce that. Well, that's the end of that. Just so nobody runs up on me and ambushes me, okay. Well, shit. What am I gonna do here? If there's a boss right here, there's no fucking way. I am way, way unprepared to do this. Oops. Oh yeah. It looks like he came back to life or whatever, so. Alright guys, I'm gonna run back to the bonfire and get all my shit back, maybe go spend some of these souls in the meantime. And then I'll meet you right back there and we'll take on that guy, because I remember fighting him the first time was sucked, but you know, we ought to do a little bit better now that we are leveled up quite a bit. And you know, he can't be that much different. So, we'll see, but I'll see you guys in a sec. Alright guys, so I'm back over here at whatever the hell I am going to fight, and I did change up my fashion souls again, although I think it looked pretty good. It's the Alva leggings with the Dancer armor and the Lothric Knight helmet. I think it looks pretty good. Also, bam! You know you like it. Alright, so let's see. Is it really just this guy again? It's kind of weird. Go ahead and throw some of that goodness on. Hey, man. Oh! Oh, what the hell? Roadhouse. Alright. Oh, he's got fucking delayed-ass attacks. Whoa. Got some delayed-ass attacks again. Another boss that does that shit. Come on, do that jump at me. God damn, he's got some reach on that fucking thing. Heal back up, because this guy's hitting like a goddamn truck. Champion Gunter. Ooh, punches, huh? Kicking Lois, really? And more of that shit. What is he doing? What is this? Ooh! Oh god. Oh my god. I don't have the stamina to counteract that shit. Dude, calm the fuck down. Oh shit. Oh. No, really, I'm fine. God damn, dude. This guy is rough. Yee-hee-hee. Whoa. Roadhouse. Jesus, man. Must cast faster. Wow. This dude is fucking brutal. Oh. No. No more grabbing. No touchy. Ugh. It's almost like you can't catch a break in between this dude's attacks. They're so ridiculous. He's so fucking fast. He's far more aggressive than the last time we fought him. Ow. Luckily, that particular, like, stomp, blow everything up attack doesn't seem to do much damage. Oh, Roadhouse, come on, dude! Oh, shit. remember to dodge towards his fucking offhand. Oh, this is a terrible place to be. Oh, and that's the end of that. Holy shit, man. This guy is rough. I'll be back, though. We'll be right back. guys, that's just my second time getting here. He's, God damn, that guy's a fucking beast. Champion Gunder, wow. Wonder if we can get that sweet halberd he was using. Yeah, I mean, obviously, you really gotta manage your stamina in this fight, because he will break your guard like nobody's fucking business. Holy shit. There's also a shiny over here I was trying not to get distracted by. The whole fight, I was like, ooh, I gotta get that. Oh, hey. Fucking Black Knight halberd? Or glaive, I guess it is now. Let's check that out. Ah, I need 28 strength. Wait a minute, 28 strength. I thought this was a dex weapon. Spin sweep, unique attack, glaive greatly reduces enemy poise. Which apparently isn't a thing anymore, like they fucking turned it off, I guess. It is also heavy as fuck. Yeah, 9. Wow. Sweet weapon, though. It's one of my favorite Dark Souls weapons. Is the Black Knight halberd. And I'm sure it's got a badass moveset in this game. In fact, so badass, I might just have to check it out. Let's take a look here. Yeah, I know. Look at that thing. Alright. Charged R2. Uh-huh. And weapon art. Huh. Alright, that's pretty fucking sweet. Wow. Yeah. Maybe I'll think about that. I'm sure it upgrades with Twinkling Titanite or whatever. But alright guys, hang on one sec. I'm going to go back to Firelink, spend these souls, and then we are going to move on. Alright, so I put some more, got a little bit more stamina, I got a little bit more dex, and a little bit more faith. Because dex faith build. Okay, well let's see where the hell, and I also put the, slightly, what the fuck is the ring called? Let me just tell you what the ring's called. Karthus Milk Ring, slightly boost dexterity, obscures rolling. I still had the, fire resistance, lightning magic resistance ring on, I forgot to change it, so I'm an idiot for that. And would you please stop looking at my character's butt? Thank you. Yeah, this is totally fucking Firelink Shrine. Weird. Is there any stuff? I wonder if that dickhead with the katana's back. Wouldn't that suck? Looks like there's nothing over here. But yeah, that should be Firelink Shrine up there, so let's go see what's going on. Is that a fucking Black Knight? Oh, fuck you, what? Black Knights? That's not fair. Luckily, if I recall, Black Knights are weak towards lightning. And he's got the axe, which means that his attacks are going to carry him right past me. Yep. Big drawback to that weapon. Ooh. Nope. Alright, so what do we got? Black Knight armor. Hey, I'm sure that's nice and light. I'm sure I won't fat roll like... Whoa, what? Hi. Shit, man. You returned the goddamn favor. God damn it. That was awful. Jesus. And I kind of screwed that one up, didn't I? Luckily, I recall that they got delay on that upswing, so you just gotta time your wake up. Yeah, here's Firelink Shrine. I wonder if we get to get behind it. Where the hell did that guy come from? I just must have completely missed him. Alright, well, before we head inside, let's go around over here, see what's what. Housekeeping, What the fuck, man? Really? What do you have? Another dude with an axe. Why are there a bunch of black knights here? Well, I suppose if it's the same Firelink shrine from the original Dark Souls, then that means that it's on top of the kiln of the first flame. Which means that it would be somewhere that the black knights would be gathered, or at least where they would be. Hang. Ooh, the Hornet Ring, hey! That boosts critical attacks, doesn't it? Hornet ring, where'd you go? Totally, there it is. Boost critical attacks, yep. From Kyren, or Ciaran, or however you want to pronounce her name. I'm terrible at pronouncing the names, just so you know, in case you hadn't figured that out by now. That is a PvP'er's best friend. Especially if you plan on doing a lot of parrying. Or fishing for... God, dude, these guys are fucking everywhere. There's also a shiny up there I really want to go get, but... Hey, man. Ooh. I got an idea. Let's not fight on this staircase. Let's go fight over here. Yeah, I want to fight over here. Where I can move. Oh, I should have equipped that ring and tested it out on this guy. Of course, I don't know if it changes the animations for backstabs. It might. Or, not changes the animation, but affects backstabs. The Hornet Ring. So backstab is a critical attack, but I think it... The wording might be wrong. It might just only affect parrying or posting. To test that at some point. Alright, well, here's that shitty tower, but there's no katana guy. Chaos Blade? Just fucking hanging out here? Really? I wonder if we can get in there through the tower, or via the tower. Let's check out the Chaos Blade. Yeah. Cursor of Unknown Origin, it's the actual Chaos Blade, it's not a Chaos Infused Sword. The sword is not unlike a thing misshapen, granting life, but never welcome to this world. In other words, cast itself. Hold. Attacks also damage the wielder, yeah. What does this scale with? It scales A with Dex. Not as good as my, not as good at all as my Lightning Katana, but, you know, Chaos Blade was always a really, really, really stupid good PvP weapon. But I don't think for PvE purposes... Unless you have your build made right. Crestfallen Knight. It's not too practical. And then, yeah, now I'm over here now. Okay, well. Let's head back around the front. If we can get to... So, is this the real Firelink Shrine? And the one I'm visiting is like an alternate dimension, kind of? Why are the thrones glowing red? There's something hanging out down there. Free shiny. Alright, let's look around upstairs first. Let's do this thorough floor-by-floor check. Alright, there's nothing back here. About outside. Seed of a giant tree is yet to fall. There's no ladder to take me up. Well, somebody got up on the roof somehow because there's a goddamn message. Huh. I wonder how... Do you have to... kind of... I wonder. There's got to be some way to get up there, right? I don't know. Let's go check the other side and see what's up with that. Although I believe the other side just leads to nothing. Although I should probably not be hauling ass around here. Because there could be something nasty waiting to kick my ass around one of these corners. This place is really eerie with nothing in it. No lights. Not exactly feeling like the safe haven that the other Firelink does. Okay. Alright, we're gonna head down here. What is this? Coiled sword fragments. Is that a key item? No. What the hell? There it is. Return the last bonfire rested at or to shrine. So this is like a infinite homeward bone type thing, sort of like the feather was from Dark Souls 2. Okay. What are you still doing here?
Well, fancy that. A lost lamb wandereth in, with nary a peep from the bell. Well, thou shouldst my purpose know. What can this old handmaid provide thee?
What the hell? She doesn't recognize me? There's a tower key. An Artorias' armor? And a priestess ring? What? What the hell is going on? I mean, I'll buy the priestess ring, sure. Why is she selling Artorias' armor? That's bizarre. Why shouldn't I tarry long? Is something going to eat me? Okay, there's no Andre here. Got a free blacksmith's hammer, though. Hooray! Alright, well, let's check. See, there's nothing where Grey Rat is. There's nothing where Carla is. Okay, this is where Yuria and Yol were. Nothing. I guess I need to go check where Irina is. The other miracle lady. It's also like dead silent in here, which it... Oh. Is there something in here? Huh. What the hell? This isn't... Aha! Ahaha! Fuck you, fake wall. Eyes of a firekeeper. What? Is that a dead firekeeper's corpse? Yeah, she's wearing the firekeeper set. What the hell? What the fuck, man? I've got so many questions about what's going on. And what the hell this place actually is. But, yeah. Well, let's check the thrones. St. Aldric of the Deep. Yeah, this is his throne or whatever. So... I'm really confused right now. And this is where that dude sits that gives you boss soul weapons and stuff, but he's gone. There's nothing up here. Let's see if I have any singing I can sell to get enough souls to buy that tower key from her. Shit I don't use. Sell the Crestfallen Knight. Yeah, I'll sell that. Sure. What the hell?
Best not.
I have that key. Well, then why the hell couldn't I open the door? Why doesn't it even give me the option to open the fucking door? I should pay more attention to these things. Hang on, guys. I'm going to look around real quick and not make you watch me stumble through the dark here. See if I can figure out a way to get on the roof. Or at least get up in the tower. So, hang on one sec. Okay, guys. So, here's the deal. I went ahead and looked it up because I couldn't figure out what the fuck to do. And apparently, I've done everything that you can do here. The tower's here, oddly enough... There's a couple really weird things. First of all, the tower is here. The doors are completely... you can't interact with them at all. You can buy the key here to unlock this tower, but this particular version of the door doesn't work at all. It doesn't grant you access to anything. Apparently, you can use this tree to get up on the roof, but I haven't been able to do it. I've been trying for about 15 minutes, so I'm just going to go ahead and give up because I'm recording. And messages that you lay down in... the Cemetery of Ash and the other Firelink shrines show up here, which is why it says key required ahead. But obviously you can't interact with the door. And there's a little bit of lore behind this area that popped up too. Apparently this is like an alternate version and is representative of what it would look like if the Enkindled failed to link the fire. This is what the flame burning out would look like. Just darkness everywhere. There's no real other info I found about this place, and apparently, I don't know if this is speculation or not, I tend not to like to quote lore, especially when it's, you know, it's all speculative, so take this with a big fucking grain of salt. Don't think that I'm telling you anything true. It's that in this place, the champion Gunder awoke too late to kindle the fire, and he just kind of gave up and sat down here, and now this alternate reality version of the world is kind of overrun with hollows, and, you know, this is all that's left. So this is what the world's going to look like if I let the fire go out. At least, that's what the speculation says. So yeah, weird. Although maybe, I'm thinking possibly, that those towers are going to lead us to a DLC area once the DLC drops, because there are two DLCs coming out for this game. So, with me done pulling lore out of my ass, I'm going to go ahead and leave this episode off here. We'll pick it right back up, and I guess we're going to head back to... This is another dead end. Well, first of all, we're going to go to Firelink and see what these eyes of the Firekeeper are about. And then after that, we're going to head back to Lothric Castle, because there was another way I could have gone that I didn't explore. So, alright. Until then, I will see you guys next time.